In the media, you always see, you know, a lone defender or a lone attacker working in isolation in front of, you know, 10 monitors all arranged around them. It looks like NASA mission control with, you know, encrypted text, which looks like, you know, a combination of Klingon and the Matrix, kind of all over the place. To break in, someone says, oh, this is encrypted using this algorithm. Give me a minute, type, 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 type. And all that Klingon and Matrix style stuff turns into, you know, plain text, and, you know, the attack succeeds. The reality is a little bit more bland. To attack a network, you tend to need to do it successfully, you need to do your homework. That means that you need to spend some time observing what happens on the system you're trying to attack, send some probes, and develop your attack over time. And this is a very long effort. It requires a lot of skill sometimes, and it's definitely not immediate. It's not click, 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 I've compromised the system. The other critical difference is the cryptography, the mathematics that defend our systems are typically the most secure part. There's this saying in computer security, trust math, trust the mathematics. The weakest component is where human beings are involved. And the design of systems and taking all these various components and adding them together and administering the system and keeping our usernames and passwords and other credentials secure. This is really what a smart attacker will go after. They'll go after the human component, not the glitz that's portrayed in Hollywood.